गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। सो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी विल कंटिन्यू विद आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर विद द टॉपिक कोलेनकाइमा। स्टूडेंट्स, सेल्स ऑफ कोलेनकाइमा टिश्यूज आर फाउंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बैंड्स। इन द फॉर्म ऑफ व्हाट? बैंड्स इन विच स्टेम्स? डाइकोट स्टेम्स, petioles of leaves and flower stalks. They have a strong resemblance with the parenchyma cells. What is the structure of colenchyma? Colenchyma cells are either circular, oval, or they are having polygonal in shape. And one more thing, that they are living in nature. These are joined together without any intercellular space. Okay students, they are thickened at the corner due to the deposits of additional wall matters. What are those additional wall matters? Cellulose and pectin. And students, the cells of these colenchyma tissues also have vacuoles in them. Okay, understood? So have a look on this diagram. Cell wall, thick cell wall is there. Let me show you. Thick cell wall is also there. Okay, then nucleus is there. Vacuole, a big vacuole is there, and this is what called cell wall here. Okay, now what are the functions of this colenchyma cells? These cells provide strength and support to the growing parts of the plant. Sometimes these cells store food also for the food prepared by the plant. Now what are sclerenchyma tissues? Students, this is the picture of sclerenchyma tissue. Understood? And you can see that the cell wall of these tissues are thick. So students, these tissues are found in hard and outer coverings of what? Nuts and seeds. They are also found where? In the stems and veins of the leaves. Students, what are the structure of this? First of all, they are dead cells, and the mature sclerenchyma cells do not have living protoplasm. There is no intercellular space between the cells. Their cell walls are thick due to lignin, and simple pits are present in the walls of sclerenchyma cells. Students, now we will learn about the functions. These cells are mechanical in nature. They provide rigidity and toughness to the different parts of the plant. Now students, one thing is there, that what is lignin? Lignin is a hard substance with great tensile strength, which means that it does not break easily on stretching. It makes the cell wall impermeable, so important substances are unable to pass through it. The cells that are heavily lignified do not have living content or the protoplasm. So students, now we will learn some comparative study. We will do this of simple permanent tissues. So I will tell you the feature and the difference between these tissues. First of all, the feature is nature. What is the nature of these three tissues? First of all, parenchyma, they are living. Colenchyma, they are also living. While sclerenchyma are dead cells. Second point, what about the occurrence? Parenchyma present in almost all soft parts of the plant. Collenchyma in dicot stems, petiole and beneath the epidermis. Sclerenchyma, it is found in hard and outer coverings of nuts and seeds. Okay, next, cell shape. Parenchyma are round or polygonal in shape, while collenchyma, they are circular, oval or polygonal in shape, while sclerenchyma can be variable in shape. What about the cell wall? Parenchyma is having thin cellulosic cell wall, while collenchyma having uneven thickening of cellulose and pectin, and this sclerenchyma have lignified secondary cell wall. Nucleus is present in both parenchyma and collenchyma, while in sclerenchyma, as you are seeing, it is absent. What about the vacuole? In parenchyma and in collenchyma, large vacuole is present, and in this collenchyma it is vacuolated, while sclerenchyma it is absent. What are the functions of these? Parenchyma is doing the function of storage of food and photosynthesis. Collenchyma provides mechanical strength and support, and this sclerenchyma provide rigidity and toughness to different parts of the plant. So students, some facts I will tell you something, that in plants, xylem conducts water and dissolved minerals in one way direction, that means from roots to different parts, while in this phloem, this conduct prepared food in two way directional, that means from leaves to different parts and again vice versa. Okay students, now we will read something about this complex permanent tissue. Students, complex permanent tissues are made up of more than one types of cells which perform together as a unit. And what is their main function? To conduct water and food material to different parts of the plant. That is why they are also called conducting tissues or vascular tissues. Listen, I will show you the diagram. This is the longitudinal section of that of a stem that is showing xylem and phloem. Okay students, now complex tissues are of two types. First of all, xylem, and second is phloem. What is a xylem? Xylem is the water conducting tissue of the plant. It conducts what? Water and dissolved minerals. From where to where? From roots to various parts of the plants. And what is its main function also? That it support, it provides support also to the plant parts. Xylem consists of four types of cells. Listen carefully. What are those four types of cells? Tracheids, vessel elements, xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers. I'll show you in this diagram. This is the diagram of tracheid and this is the diagram of vessel element. Okay student, these are the components of xylem tissue. Now, what are the functions of this tissue? First of all, it is responsible for the upward movement of water and dissolved minerals. From where to where? Yes, from root to leaves. Then the lignified cell wall of xylem tissue, it provides mechanical support to the different parts of the plant. So students, now we will continue it in the next video. Till then, stay at home, stay safe, and wash your hands again and again thoroughly with soap and water. Thank you.